Hi, welcome back to Market Sense. Now, we've seen a few of these shoemaking companies doing very well off late. I mean, Bata has been a prime example, but I don't think Relaxo or Liberty are too far behind. And now Liberty is eyeing a significant turnover growth. They've decided to merge an arm, Liberty Retail, with itself. Let's get in Adesh Gupta, CEO of Liberty Shoes, who joins us now on the show to speak about what's the way ahead. Good having you, Mr. Gupta. Thanks for joining in. You've merged Liberty Retail with Liberty Shoes. Can you tell us the rationale behind the merger?
Yes, you're right. We have merged the retail company, which is called as Liberty Retail Revolution Limited, in this current financial year, after the necessary approvals from the Government of India. And the idea was that, you know, we would like to merge at a time when retail is making profits in the company, because Liberty Shoe Limited is the flagship and mother company, and Liberty Retail Revolution Limited is a, you know, subsidiary which is not a listed company. The idea was to merge at a time when the company is making profit in retail, and also to give the benefit to the shareholders and also the stakeholders for at a time when the company is making profit and also growing. Now, if we have to expand, you know, in retail, it was a necessary, you know, merger for us to expand in a big way into our retail footprint in Pan India and also overseas, to see that the rapid expansion in growth will give us the top line and the bottom line, you know, benefits in the balance sheet. Liberty Retail Revolution, you know, has been so far in the mother company, only 50% of the value or half the value was captured in the turnover. But now with this merger, we would be able to capture the full value, which is the MRP at which the shoes are sold in the store. So we would be able to capture the differential value in the store, which will give us also the higher bottom line as compared to in the past.
After, Mr. Gupta, so then could you quantify the synergies, and by when can we see the benefits of this merger reflecting on your financials?
Well, we already see the benefits coming in this year itself in terms of the top line growth and as well as in the bottom line. But as we move, expand and we move fast and expand our retail further, there will be a further huge increase in the turnover of the company as well as in the bottom line, because from 100 stores at present we have plans to grow this to a bigger level, which we can't quantify now. But our objective is that we should grow strongly in retail.
Mr. Gupta, you've indicated 40% growth in turnover for this year. What will be the drivers of this growth be?
In the current fiscal, we are looking to about 35 to 40% growth. And it is primarily because we have three verticals. One is domestic, the second is institutions, and third is exports. Fortunately for the company, all three verticals are also expanding and are growing, which is giving us this cumulative growth of 35 to 40% in the current fiscal. And as we expand our retail network, as we grow in our footprints outside India, where we have recently opened a store in Sri Lanka, and we are hoping to open soon one store in Dubai, and the retail expansion story is also going on in the market overseas. Besides that, the institution business is also growing very rapidly. This year we saw almost about 50% growth in our institution business, where we sell Warrior safety footwear to industry as well as to the hospitality sector. As a result of this, the cumulative effect is that, you know, the growth of 35 to 40% is giving us a sign that we are on the right track after 4 years of hard work of making this company a unique company in the world by implementing a pull system as against push system, which is the latest business tool amongst all business processes we have done in the last 4 years.
And what is the outlook then on raw material prices? Do we see margin expansion going forward?
Well, we are not using rubber per se, but we are using polyurethane materials and also some other materials which which are dependent on imports, and oil prices are softening. So we see, as well as, you know, the currency, you know, rupee is appreciating. So as a result of this, we see some downward trend in the prices of raw materials. But it is a you know, regular feature. You know, these prices comes up and down. But as we are a strong brand and the consumer is looking for fashionable styles, quality and comfort, and if we can provide them, these smaller changes would not really matter for us. The consumer is willing to pay even a higher price in the products if we are able to, you know, manage our, you know, quality and, you know, the fashion and also the lifestyle changes which are happening in the marketplace.
What's the outlook for ad expenditure as a percentage of sales? Will it be more than the last fiscal?
We believe in expanding our retail, which will be our best advertisement and promotion as a company. However, we do spend you know, a lot of money on publicity, but compared to the turnover, it is between 2-3%. So it is not going to increase further in the coming year or coming years.
Now, Mr. Gupta, your stock has performed well in the last year. It's up over something like 80%. But surprisingly, there is no FII investment in the company. Have you of late been approached by any foreign investors?
You are right that the stock has done pretty well, and we're also happy and excited that, you know, that finally our performance is being awarded by the stakeholders or shareholders. Of course, when the company is doing well, naturally, you know, a lot of FIIs will approach us. We are in discussion stage. We have not finalized any dilution of equity, but we are seriously looking at, you know, these options for us so that we can, you know, expand our business fast in the coming years to give stakeholders and shareholders a better value of their money.
Right, thanks Mr. Gupta for joining in and giving us that perspective. Adani Enterprises is up 18%, 448. That's a massive, massive move to a stock which was anyways doing well. Now trading at the highest point of the day yet again. Oh my God, it's a stunning move. None of the others have done as well. Adani Port is still up only 7%, but Enterprises has really moved up in the session. By the way, what is moving up now is AB Nuvo. So there's a price volume breakout that we're just seeing into it. Can it do more is the question. Prakash, Aditya Birla Nuvo, price that